I've been playing as Shulk for a while, and the game has been getting a little stale. I know, I'll try a new character. I just got this new mage character called Melia. I should try her out. Dang, she has a lot of ether arts. She'll be great with Sharla. Wait a second. Why isn't her talent gauge going up? I'm auto-attacking, but the center art isn't filling up. What the heck are those arts for? Why is there these orbs floating over her head? Why is she glowing? What the heck is going on here? Brr, mages. That's probably what was going through your mind when you first played as Melia Antiqua. The most challenging character to play as, but don't let that stop you from using her. If you know how to use her, Melia can kick some serious butt, and I highly recommend playing as her when fighting the Telethia in the Machina Forest. The issue is in how Melia plays. She is mechanically different from any other party member, and this can make it hard to play as her. Don't worry about this. I'm here to help. I've played this game a lot in the past 2 weeks, and I've figured out most of the mechanics. This isn't a guide on how to make Melia broken. This is a guide on how to use her, with no spoilers of the 7th party member. Stick around to the end for some helpful hints, including some hints on how to use her in chain attacks. I'll start with her arts. A bunch of her arts act as buffs, like Summon Flare, Aqua, Bolt, and etc. These buffs can increase stats and bolster the party. Every time you summon an elemental, a special orb will start floating over Melia's head. The elementals are Summon Bolt, which raises ether, Summon Flare, which grants a strength up buff, Summon Aqua, which grants a regeneration buff, but it isn't very good, I wouldn't recommend using it. Later on you can unlock Summon Wind, which grants agility up, Summon Earth will reduce physical damage. I haven't unlocked Summon Ice yet, but I'm sure it does something. Summon Copy will summon the last used elemental, and it is very good art. Healing Gift will give some of Melia's HP to another party member, but I don't recommend using this one either. Burst End will lower enemy ether defense and physical defense, but only while in elemental burst. I'll get to that a little bit later on. Hypnotize will make an enemy go to sleep. Shadow Stitch will bind an enemy in place. Spear Break is Melia's only physical art. Starlight Kick is Melia's topple art, and after a spear break will instantly topple an enemy without needing to break them. Mind Blast. Mind Blast will inflict Art Seal on an enemy, but only in Elemental Burst. But what is this Elemental Burst? Allow me to explain. Melia's talent art is unique because it doesn't fill up with an auto attack like the rest of the party. Instead, Melia can use her talent art whenever she has a summoned elemental, such as Bolt, Flare, Wind, etc. Summoning an elemental causes a massive damage and will fill up Melia's talent gauge. Once her talent gauge is filled up, she will enter an elemental burst state. In this state, Melia becomes super OP. Her regular elemental discharge will increase damage, and her arts, Burst End, and Mind Blast become available to use. It's also important to know that Melia will stay in elemental burst state longer if she is at high tension. Higher tension can be helpful in many instances, including chain attacks. A chain attack can be activated when the player has a full party gauge. Chain attacks can be used to topple faced Mechon, increase the potency of healing arts, and deal massive damage. So what does this have to do with Melia? I'm getting to that, please wait a little bit. When a player activates a chain attack, they can improve the chain attack by chaining arts with the same color. There are several different colors of arts. There are orange arts, purple arts, blue arts, red arts, pink arts for breaking, green arts for topple, and yellow arts for daze. However, talent arts are different because they clear the link of any purple, green, etc. arts in order to change the colors. Depending on how many summoned elementals there are, Melia can use her talent art multiple times in a chain attack. Here are some examples. Here I have a party consisting of Shulk, Melia, and Dunban. I activate a chain attack and use Shulk's air slash to break the enemy. As it goes to Melia, I could use Starlight Kick, but I'm gonna use Elemental Discharge, dealing massive damage and changing the color of the chain link. As Dunban uses a 3x Steel Strike, he's able to deal over 11,000 damage, resulting in a chain attack that not only topples the unique monster, but also deals 26,500 damage. This can be very hard to do with an Aether user, but with Melia, it's easy. This isn't the only way you can use a chain attack. You can switch from a red art to a purple art, or you can spam the elemental discharge to deal immense damage. Go crazy! I hope this guide was helpful. Melia is an awesome character that newcomers to the series can easily miss. Don't make the mistake game critics do of using the same three characters beginning to end. If you found this guide useful, that's good. Please share it with other people who might be struggling with Melia. Anyways, I'll see you later. Go and make some crazy build with her or something like that. Anyways, bye.